to Kansas, gateway to Oz. Under the rainbow, this is where it was. Hollyhocks and red ripe tomatoes, hand-churned homemade ice cream. Let me tell you, Kansas is more than tornadoes. It's the best part of Dorothy's dream.
Today on Around Kansas, we start with a story about Ken Weidner, a Kansas farmer whose true passion is the history of Western Kansas. Next, learn about Carpenter Bees, a bumblebee lookalike that comes out in the spring. Then enjoy a poem from Ron Wilson. And we'll end with the Governor's Proclamation Day on April 29th to mark the 150th anniversary of the Chisholm Trail. Closed captioning brought to you by Ag Promo Source. Together we grow. Learn more at agpromosource.com. This segment brought to you by Brown Chevrolet Buick in Waumego, just a short drive down the Yellow Brick Road. Well, good morning. It's Wednesday. I'm Frank.
I'm Deb.
And this is Around Kansas. Good morning to you.
And we are into the middle of April already.
Middle of April already. Good.
And I've been celebrating my birthday. Thank you, everybody, for the thoughts and wishes. And, yeah, didn't get as many presents as I expected. You know, I thought the mailman would be just breaking his back bringing the presents, you know. Of course, checks, it doesn't take a lot to carry a check. You know what, Frank?
Yeah, right.
Have we talked about this before? There was maybe we did. There was a preacher down south, Reverend Roosevelt Franklin from Macon, Georgia. And remember when Billy Preston had Nothing From Nothing Leaves Nothing, that big hit? Well, that was kind of the Reverend Roosevelt Franklin's theme song. And he says, you know, some folks sends cards and some folks sends letters. You can't put no money in no card. You know, talking about a postcard. He didn't want any postcards. He wanted letters, you know, where you could stick a check in the envelope for some cash. So
Roosevelt Franklin. Now, that just sounds like a certain preacher's name.
Doesn't it?
Roosevelt Franklin.
Yeah, he was meant to be. Reverend Roosevelt Franklin. He was something else. He was quite the entertainment when I was a kid. Yeah, but it was a wonderful birthday.
And, oh, well, good.
Yeah.
You're good. So you've been all over the state. I mean, you've been kind of a stranger.
Honey, I ought to get frequent flyer miles just for zooming back and forth on I-70, you know, if nothing else, and Highway 83 up and down, and you name it, just everywhere. We've been working on our documentary, you know, Thoth's Dragon. We've been working on that. So we're filming and just life. You know, Dr. Jake is really busy. It's a busy time of the year. Babies. We got new babies at home. Yeah. We got two new horses.
Wow. Oh, that's right.
Yeah, yes. And they are so stinking cute. So the first foal, this mare was old. So she's like up in her 20s. And so we were pretty concerned about her. So we got her all segregated from the other horses and everything. And she's a paint, and her baby is a paint. And so she's just like a mini Patches, and she's so feminine. She's just sort of fine and frail and everything. Well, then 4 days later, we get a little boy, and his mama is a halflinger, and his daddy is a halflinger and a Shetland pony. So just built like a Mack truck, and he's just like all boy. It's so funny to watch him. He's dark brown and she's just white and fragile, and he's just this dark brown little Mack truck of a horse. And but oh, Frank, it's so much fun to watch him.
And well, it's good that you're back on the farm.
It is good. Life is good on the farm.
Yeah. So, well, we have some good stories this morning, so stick around. We'll let you know what they're all about.
To see this show and past episodes of Ag AM in Kansas, go online to agamandkansas.com.
Soil is the life of a farm, and for 25 years, SureCrop Liquid Crop Nutrition has helped growers produce abundant quality crops while preserving and improving the soils they steward. SureCrop offers complete soil and plant analysis with cropping recommendations, delivery direct to your on-farm storage, and quality crop nutrition custom blended for your field. Choose SureCrop for the assurance of excellence for your soil. Call today or visit their website for more information.
Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego is driven by the spirit of American ingenuity. Come in for a new Chevrolet car, truck, or SUV. If we don't have exactly what you want, we'll find it for you. And we also have a great selection of used cars. We make sure you have an easy, fun, and transparent sales experience that saves you time and money. But if you want high-pressure salesmen and hours spent in the finance office, you'll just have to go elsewhere. Brown Chevrolet Buick in Wamego. We're making car buying great again.
Ag Promo Source is a unique group of marketing specialists with one mission: help your ag business grow. Each affiliate has their own area of expertise, and they work together to bring you advice, products, and services. To get started, visit agpromosource.com. Ag Promo Source, together we grow.
Valley Vet Supply is devoted to providing information and professional quality products at reasonable prices.
Supply. This segment brought to you by Kansas Regenerative Medicine Center. Your stem cells, your health, your life.
See, I told you we'd come back. Well, anyway, we have lots of stories today, and they're okay. Now that we're in the middle of April, we got all of this stuff out in front of us this year, the 150
it's
celebration,
huge.
And we're
huge.
Talking about Nebraska. Sorry, but
no, but we had the 150th of Nebraska, but mm-hmm. Kansas has so many 150th yeah. anniversaries this year, it's just crazy. Like I've said, this is the third most important year in Kansas history, 1867. So we've got Chisholm Trail, we've got Medicine Lodge Peace Treaty. We've got so many events marking the 150th this year, and so many historic sites. And one of the people that you're going to see at a lot of them is Ken Weidner, and he will be at our big event in July. July, for us, is the culmination of a lot of the stuff in western Kansas at Fort Wallace. And Ken is just one of these amazing people. When we started putting together the events at Fort Wallace and looking at the big encampment with the dozens of reenactors we've got, you know, Ken's name is one, it's like he's got to be there. He's going to be there for our annual meeting April 23rd, too. Frank, just takes it to the nth degree. He has gone back and figured out how the Plains tribes would have done all these things, like when he talks about using every part of the buffalo, he figured out how to do that exactly the way the Plains tribes would have done. So he's a living historian. He's like a teacher. He's phenomenal. This is one that will get the kids' attention. I promise you, when Ken shows up, it will get the kids' attention.
Okay. I think I have met him a couple of times at like Kansas Sample.
Oh,
I think
sure.
He's always
yeah.
there at the camp
yeah.
out.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure. He's pretty amazing. He's just one of the amazing people. But let's take a look at the art and talent and ability of Ken Weidner.
As Kansas marks the 150th anniversary of many events in 2017, one of the exhibits you are likely to see is a teepee with tanned hides and tools, all crafted in the manner of the 1860s Plains tribes. The man wears face paint and sports a scalp lock, and frankly, it's quite intimidating, but the blue eyes may give pause. Ken Weidner of Copeland is a farmer of German descent. He makes his living in southwest Kansas growing wheat, milo, and corn, and raising cattle on the family farm. Though farming is the life he was born into, his passion is the history of western Kansas. Ken's interest in early western history began in grade school, evolving into his involvement with black powder guns and eventually the fur trade era, rendezvous camps. The artistry and challenge of learning to use every part of a buffalo interested Ken in the Native American culture. His attention eventually focused on the Southern Cheyenne people who followed the herds of buffalo across the Plains states, including Kansas. In the past 30 years, Ken has participated in various living history camps in Wyoming, South Dakota, Nebraska, Colorado, New Mexico, Oklahoma, Texas, and of course, Kansas. Research and actual hands-on experience go hand in hand in crafting, understanding, and mastering the creation and use of everyday articles. Most of the items you see in Whirlwind's teepee have been handcrafted by Ken. Brain-tanned buffalo robes, rawhide parfleches of various shapes and sizes, beaded bags, bow and arrows, hand-dyed Stroud wool blankets, German silver bridles, and Indian saddles. Years of studying actual accounts in books and journals, living primitive camp life at every opportunity, and museum research trips where he's been able to examine historic artifacts has made Ken a sought-after expert in the material culture of the Southern Plains Indians. Commitment to the craft and attention to detail has opened doors for Ken both locally and across the country. You'll see his work displayed or included in hands-on exhibits at historic sites and museums such as Fort Larned National Park site and the Little Bighorn Battlefield, and most notably the Smithsonian National Museum of the American Indian in Washington, D.C. His work is so widely recognized because he is so disciplined and devoted to his craft, and thankfully to sharing it with the rest of us.
Hey, I'm Clark Victory. I grew up right here on this little ranch near Chelsea, Oklahoma. Roped and ranched all my life, and a few years ago I had an injury that created a what they call a frozen shoulder in layman's terms. It got to the point that I couldn't reach, I couldn't sleep, I couldn't do anything. After speaking with the surgeon in Tulsa, he finally told me that he could make my shoulder better if he did surgery, but he absolutely couldn't fix it. I decided that, you know, maybe I better listen to my friend John, and I called Kansas Regenerative Medical Center. I talked to Patrick Farley and was just excited about the whole aspect of going up there and having the opportunity to focus on getting better. The next morning at 8:30, went into the clinic, did the stem cell replacement. By 12:30, my wife and I had had lunch and was driving back to Chelsea. I feel better. We work around here. Some days we work pretty hard around here, and like any older guy does, I get pretty sore, pretty tired, but my right shoulder doesn't get sore. It's like a baby's arm.
Fort Wallace stood on the frontier in the midst of the Plains Indians Wars on a major stage route and rail line. Beside the 1865 stagecoach station, a modern museum with thousands of artifacts tell that story, like the fossil of a 40-foot plesiosaur is suspended from the ceiling. Located on Highway 40, midway between Hayes and Colorado Springs, the Fort Wallace Museum is as welcome a sight today as the fort itself in the 1860s. Discover the fightingest fort in the West.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Soybean Commission. Progress powered by Kansas farmers.
I'll start. Okay, the downside of spring is all the insects coming out. And I am a big supporter of honeybees. You know, honeybees have had some issues over the past few years. They've had their problems. But I'm a big supporter of honeybees, and we got to have all these other bees. They pollinate things, which is really important, people. Pollination is important. But Frank, having grown up on a farm as a kid, I can't tell you how many times I was stung by something. Hornet, wasp, yellow jacket, what we call Japanese hornets. I found out they were not Japanese. Bumblebee. Have you ever been stung by a bumblebee?
No.
Holy cow. You might as well get shot. I'm not kidding. So you're going to talk about one that's a really big nuisance this time of year, and that's the carpenter bees,
yeah.
Are they a mess or what?
Well, it was really kind of a learning experience for me, too, to learn about carpenter bees. Because, I mean, you think about termites, but carpenter bees.
They termites. Take it to a whole new level, yeah. Don't they?
Yeah.
Yeah, it ain't bad enough you got termites. Now you got a termite that can sting you. You know, it's and again. I mean, yeah, it's pretty scary.
And not only that, but you can hear them underground.
Oh, is that scary? Is that scary or what?
Yes. So, anyway.
Or in the wall of your house,
yeah.
In the wall of your barn. Mm-hmm. Oh, my gosh.
So, anyway, so we're going to hear a story now about carpenter bees.
Watch for the horror film later.
Spring has sprung, the sun is shining, baby birds are chirping, bees are buzzing, and bees are stinging. Ouch. Bees are a vital part of the food chain, providing essential pollination duties that keep our environment intact. But some of them can be pretty scary, too, and are best avoided. Take the carpenter bee, for example. While it resembles the bumblebee, it nests in wood rather than the ground where the bumblebee burrows. This industrious large black bee emerges around April, looking for a place to nest and a partner with whom to share life. After mating, the fertilized females evacuate tunnels in wood and lay their eggs within a series of small cells. The cells are provisioned with a ball of pollen on which the larvae feed, emerging as adults in late summer. The entrance hole and tunnels are perfectly round and about the diameter of your finger. Coarse sawdust, the color of fresh-cut wood, will often be present beneath the entry hole, and burrowing sounds may be heard from within the wood. Female carpenter bees may excavate new tunnels for egg-laying or enlarge and reuse old ones. The extent of damage to wood, which has been utilized for nesting year after year, may be considerable. According to the University of Kentucky's research findings, male carpenter bees are quite aggressive, often hovering in front of people who are around the nests. The males also lack stingers. Females, however, can inflict a painful sting, but seldom will unless they're handled or molested. Carpenter bees resemble bumblebees, but the upper surface of their abdomen is bare and shiny black. Bumblebees have a hairy abdomen with at least some yellow markings. And if you're close enough to examine their abdomens, it's probably too late to warn you.
KFRM is one of the largest farm radio stations in the nation, dedicated to informing and entertaining rural listeners from northern Oklahoma to southwestern Nebraska. You can catch KFRM in many ways. Of course, 550 on the AM dial, streaming at KFRM.com, or on your smartphone by going to the TuneIn Radio app, or on Ag AM in Kansas on Tuesdays and Facebook every day of the week. KFRM, tune us in. You'll be glad you did.
Tarwater Farm and Home has been family-owned and operated since its beginning in 1978. What you need for farm and agriculture, lawn and garden, clothing and footwear, and so much more. You'll be surprised at what you'll find in this huge store. They have what you need, and lots of it. So come take a look. You'll discover that customer service is first and foremost. Always has been with the Tarwaters. Tarwater Farm and Home, 4107 North Topeka Boulevard.
As fourth-generation farmers themselves, Heinen Brothers Ag Service understands the risk and rewards of farming. So when it comes to quality aerial and ground application, fertilizer, ag chemicals, and anhydrous ammonia, call Heinen Brothers Ag today, 800-760-4964.
This segment brought to you by Kansas Grain Sorghum, growers working together. Find out more at ksgrainsorghum.org.
When the open range era came to an end, the homesteaders and settlers moved into Kansas and started building something that would change the life of the cowboys forever. I'm referring to fences. And this poem is based on the true story of the invention of barbed wire. It's called The Death of Open Range. Let me tell you of a time when open range was in its prime. Cowboys rode their horses forth and drove the huge herds of cattle north. We could ride all over this great land, unfettered by the human hand. Then a farmer over Illinois way invented something that's used to this day. His name was Mr. Joseph Glidden. He was doing the homesteader's bidding. He took a pair of heavy pliers and wrapped barbs around a long piece of wire. The barbs' sharp points kept stock in or out. It could be used for fencing all about. For the open range, it was a turn of events, because barbed wire made it easy to string a fence. Barbed wire succeeded more than Glidden had planned. Soon fences crisscrossed the open land. The Old West changed with Glidden's invention, and it caused the cowboys apprehension. No more could we ride over free open range, and the cowboys' role would be forever changed. Homesteaders and nesters scarred this land and changed the role of the old cowhand. The cowboys' work continues on, but the days of the open range are gone. That open range would have no more hope. That's why cowboys called barbed wire the devil's rope. Happy trails.
Next time you see a beautiful field of corn, reach out and thank the farmers who work tirelessly to raise corn for livestock feed, renewable fuels, and exports to feed a growing world population. The farmers on the Kansas Corn Commission work for Kansas corn with grower-funded checkoff dollars that support foreign and domestic market development, research, promotion, and education to expand opportunities for Kansas farmers. To learn more, visit kscorn.com.
Buffalo Bill Cody earned his legendary title in Oakley. Bring the family and come celebrate Oakley's pioneering history and unique geography at two sites, the Buffalo Bill Cultural Center and the Fick Fossil Museum. Cody's statue marks his achievements and welcomes visitors to the Cultural Center. The Fick Fossil Museum houses world-class fossils and artifacts. You'll find Oakley at the hub of U.S. Highways 83 and 40 and I-70. Stop for the legend. Stay for the day. Discover Oakley. This segment brought to you by Kansas Farm Bureau, the voice of agriculture. To join today or more information, go to kfb.org or find us on Facebook and Twitter.
Welcome back. We did this last year. For some reason, the older you get, the faster the year goes. And here we are, about halfway through the month of April already.
Yeah, and I'm not even riding 2016 yet, I'm way behind.
Yeah.
And we've got such a busy year coming up. There's so many events this year, so many great events coming up to take the kids to so that they can find out about Kansas history. And one of the things that I love about sharing history and what we've got coming up with the Chisholm Trail, the Proclamation Day coming up in Abilene, that's so important is the Chisholm Trail and the cattle drives. That's so important to how we became, such a big beef producer. So that's so important to the Kansas economy. So it's not just that something happened 150 years ago, oh, big deal. No, that created an industry in Kansas that, of course, as we at Ag AM know, is really important. So you get to see the evolution of those things, and how they came about. So Abilene, of course, is marking 150th of the Chisholm Trail, as are many other communities in Kansas throughout the year. And just so much fun.
In an earlier show, we had talked about Abilene. We talked about the song Abilene.
We did.
And I erroneously said, well, that's about Abilene, Texas. But I did the research after one of our viewers did say,
Roger Ringer.
He's wrong.
Roger Ringer.
And I admit I was wrong. And I should have known that because I was working at KSL in Salina when the movie Abilene was made about Abilene, Kansas, and the song Abilene, Abilene is about Abilene, Kansas. So there.
That's really sad that it took all of that for you to come full circle and figure it all out, Frank, all that background.
It is amazing what you can find out on Google.
It is. Google that stuff. That's
Google,
right.
Google, tell me about Abilene.
All righty, let's watch about Proclamation Day in Abilene. Abilene, Abilene.
Events marking the 150th anniversary of the Chisholm Trail have already begun, but there are dozens more in Kansas, Oklahoma, and Texas as communities along the way recall the trail's storied past. Abilene is marking the Governor's Proclamation Day on April 29th with ceremonies beginning at noon. Among all the whereases and therefores lies the heart of the celebration, declaring the historical relevance of the Chisholm Trail to the state of Kansas. Whereas, more than 4 million Texas Longhorn cattle came up the trail. Whereas, the Chisholm Trail reached the communities of Caldwell, Wichita, Newton, North Newton, Durham, and Abilene, with branches to Ellsworth and beyond. Whereas, you get the picture. Whereas, we are going to celebrate big. Senator Randall Hardy will read the declaration, and then the Buckeye Saddle Club will carry the document in a saddlebag on horseback for the first leg of its journey to Texas. The rider will hand off to a fresh horse and rider about 20 miles down the trail, continuing through Newton, Wichita, Clearwater, Mayfield, and finally to the state boundary in Caldwell. The Oklahoma Proclamation riders will meet the final Kansas rider, Sam Wiley, and his mounted police escorts at the intersection of Main and First Streets. The proclamations from each state will be exchanged at noon on Saturday, May 6, during Caldwell's Chisholm Trail Festival. Proclamation Day in Abilene will feature our friends Ron Wilson and Jeff Davidson, and Ken Spurgeon will be on hand for a screening of Home on the Range. We are excited to turn the Great Plains Theater into the Western Stockyards again. This is just one of many Chisholm Trail related events, so check their website for the schedule and we will do our best to keep ahead of the cowboys.
Well, it's been a great day, folks. I'm Deb.
Oh, I'm Frank.
We'll see you somewhere
around Kansas if we're awake.
closed captioning brought to you by Ag Promo Source. Together we grow. Learn more at agpromosource.com.
Hollyhocks and red ripe tomatoes. Hand-churned homemade ice cream. Let me tell you, Kansas is more than tornadoes. We're the best part of Dorothy's dream. We're the best part of Dorothy's dream.
Watch Ag AM in Kansas online at agamandkansas.com.